It's just the need to accept the reality. Good morning to one and all present here. Respected Madam Principal, Manager Sir, teaching and non-teaching staff, and of course, you my dear friends. By the resolution of 42-112 on 7th of December 1987, the United Nations General Assembly decided to observe 26th of June as the International Day Against Drug Abuse, or also known as the International Anti-Drugs Day. This day helps us and also reminds us to get a nation free of drugs. In the present time, there are various reasons why people may fall into drug addiction. Some include industrialization and, of course, urbanization. People nowadays prefer to live life in isolation. These factors also give rise to a new kind of behavior in the youth nowadays, which also include individualism, which puts into isolation. They also get into permissiveness. The people think it's not good or it's too much modern to socialize with other people, and that thus it would withdraw their lives in their personal times. It is an obvious fact that the addiction to drugs is ruining the lives of millions and millions, and as a whole, the nation. The government has been taking many proactive measures in order to help the people who are addicted to drugs, and also keep a key check on this destructive habit of our life. The most significant step is to spread the awareness of an anti-drug nation. As I mentioned before, there are many reasons why people may fall into drug addiction. And other than industrialization and urbanization, the rest which top the chart is tariff statement. The youth nowadays think that taking drugs, taking alcohol or smoking cigarettes, also eating tobacco, is a style statement, or which makes them look cool, or also have cool factor. But they don't realize how bad it's actually. Second comes peer influence. As often said from the old times, our behavior and attitude depends on the people we go around on a daily basis. And thus, if we go around people who are addicted to drugs, we too will be the same. Yes, addicted to drugs. The second comes de-stress themselves. People nowadays have hectic life schedules, and this hectic life schedule is full of stress, and they think drug could be a medium to help themselves get out of the stress. Our Indian government has in fact taken various steps to help the drug addicts come back from their addiction, by conducting various awareness campaigns and also by opening drug rehabilitation centers in each nook and corner of the city for these drug addicts to get back to their normal lives. The one who is addicted to drugs finds so difficult to get back from this addiction, and thus his or her own bodily conditions help them to get up, continue the drug addiction. They don't realize how bad it is for their health and thus continue. But at the time they realize it's so bad for their health, it might be too late. All those people who are drug addicted shall see a helping hand, and thus it should be us to help them to get, and of course encourage getting out of this drug addiction. We should be the one to encourage, support and help them get back to their normal lives and also lead a healthy life. And as this International Anti-Drugs Day reminds us to do so, we must follow it. Hoping that you all understand how important it is to lead an anti-drug life and also create an anti-drug nation in this world. Thank you and have a wonderful day.
Escapism. The idea that medicines may address complications. Peer pressure. Curiosity to experiment. single theorems, correlative theorems, inferiority complex, pressure of study, pressure regarding each other, pressure regarding business, competitive mentality, plenty of earning at a young age and lack of wisdom to spend it. Signs of drug abuse, depression, change in appearance, shabby dressing sense, lack of communication, withdrawal
effect, which was shown there. But eventually what happens is it leads to depression and frustration. It is only that initial feeling of power that you get, but gradually it causes you, your whole self, physically, emotionally, you get drained out, and it leads to frustration, and the depression becomes so severe that finally you feel like taking your own life. And that is a cause for hurting so many people around you, family members, those who love you. Everybody gets affected by your depression and other guilt feelings that you have after that. So the best thing is to say no immediately. Right? Whenever you are tempted, say no. Don't ever start. Because if you start, you are on a downtrend to disaster. So have the guts, have the courage, even if you are tempted by others, by your friends, to say no. It should be an emphatic no. Alright, now please stand up and we will take a pledge that we will start a war against drug abuse. We will neither use it ourselves nor allow others to use it, and that we will report anybody who is addicted to drugs, because they are a cancer in society. So raise your right hands.
I understand that drug addiction is a crime.
That has serious physical and emotional effects.
That would hurt me.
My family and my friends.
And all those who love me.
Realizing the serious danger of drug abuse,
I accept and pledge
to lead a drug free life.
I hereby declare war
on drug abuse and drug abusers.
I will inspire others in my student community
to avoid falling into the trap of drug abuse
by spreading the message
of the harmful effects of drugs,
including
how drug abuse destroys lives
and negatively affects our ability to achieve our goals.
I will also consider
that my social responsibility
to report the actions
of any person
who engaged in drug abuse
or drug trafficking,
so as to save them
and society from destruction.
This I do solemnly.